Good morning, everyone. This video is for the students of class 7th, subject English. Book An Alien Hand, lesson number 1, The Tiny Teacher. And this is my lecture number 1 for lesson 1, The Tiny Teacher. So, dear, till now we all were reading our main course book, that is Honeycomb. Now, from today, we will start a second book, that is supplementary reader, named as An Alien Hand. The first chapter in the book is The Tiny Teacher. The Tiny Teacher talks about the tiniest creature who teaches us a lot many things. So now, we will come to know who is this tiniest teacher. The chapter starts with the question, have you seen the smallest and the wisest insect? Is it a fly? No. Is it the mosquito? No. Is it the worm? No. Then who is it? It's an ant. An ant is the smallest but an intelligent and hard-working creature. Every day, a small ant arrives at work very early and starts work immediately. Now, in this chapter, we will talk about the tiniest teacher, that is an ant. So, this chapter deals with a number of facts about ants. Here, we will read them one by one. The first fact is, an ant uses its feelers or antennae to talk to other ants by passing messages through them. As you can see in the picture also, there are two ants who are communicating through each other by touching their antennae or feelers. It is their way of communicating or passing messages to each other. The second fact is, watch a row of ants moving up or down the wall. Each ant greets all the others coming from the opposite direction by touching their feelers. Now, it is the way of their greeting each other that whenever they walk in a line or up and down anywhere, they always greet each other by touching their feelers. Third fact is, there are many kinds of ants. Here I have mentioned some of them. Argentine ant, black house ant, bull ant, coastal brown ant and fire ant. As in the third fact, I told you that there are so many kinds of ants. The commonest among them are the black and the red ones as we see in our daily life. The fifth fact is, where do they live? Now the question arises, where do these ants live? They live in their comfortable homes known as nests or ant hills. As you can see in the pictures also. Now the sixth fact is, each ant hill has hundreds of little rooms and passages. You can see in the pictures also. These are the ant hills having different rooms. In some of these rooms, the queen ant lays eggs. Now, these different rooms are for different purposes. And in these ant hills, one or two rooms are for the queen ant just to lay eggs. The seventh fact is, others are nurseries for the young ones called grubs. That in ant hills, one or two rooms are used as nurseries for the young ones of ants known as grubs. The eighth fact is, workers have their reserved quarters. Workers here mean working ants have their reserved rooms in the anthill. They spend most of their time searching for food. Now in ant community also, we can see that there are working ants, there is a queen ant, there are normal ants and there are soldier ants also. So each ant is supposed to do its work honestly. Now the working ant spend most of their time searching for food and working. Now the ninth fact is, some rooms serve as storehouses for this food. This point means that in ant hills there are one or two rooms used for storing the food collected by the working ants. The tenth fact is, soldiers have separate barracks, or you can say rooms, in ant hills. Now there are soldier ants who used to guide the whole community of ants. They used to protect them from any kind of danger, and they have a separate room in ant hill where they are not supposed to harm any grub or any other ant. Now the 11th fact is, no worker has ever tried to live in a soldier's house. No soldier has ever gone out searching for food. Now in ant community also, there are worker ants and there are soldier ants, and they do their own work honestly and they never interfere in each other's work. Like, no worker ant ever tried to live in a soldier's house, and similarly no soldier has ever gone out searching for food. So they are supposed to do their work honestly without disturbing each other. The 12th fact is, so you see, an ant's life is very peaceful. Why peaceful? Because all the ants are supposed to do their work honestly without interfering in each other's work, and they are very loyal to the land where they live. Each does its share of work intelligently and bravely and never fight with other members of the group because they all believe in teamwork. Now, the 13th fact talks about queen ant. Now, who is queen ant? It is the mother of whole population. It lives for about 15 years. It has a pair of wings but bites them off or cuts them off after its wedding flight. This flight takes place on a hot summer day when the queen leaves the nest and goes out to meet a male ant. On its return to earth, it gets rid of its wings and then does nothing but lay eggs. So this was about queen ant. Now the 14th fact talks about the life cycle of ants. So basically, what is the life cycle of ants? First, the eggs hatch and grubs come out. When the grubs come out, soldiers used to guard them, and workers feed and clean them and also carry them daily for airing, exercise and sunshine. Now, after airing, exercise and sunshine, grubs become cocoons and die without food or any activity for 3 to 4 weeks. After this period, cocoons break and perfect ants appear. When a perfect ant appears, it's time for teaching and training them. New ants learn their duties from old ants as workers, soldiers, cleaners, etc. After their training, small ants are ready to go out into the big world of work. So this was the life cycle of ants. Now, the 15th point talks about an ant hill. What is an ant hill? An ant hill is a home not only for ants, but also for some other creatures such as beetles, lesser breeds of ants, green fly. Now the question arises, why do ants allow these creatures to live in their ant hills or houses? The answer is that some of these creatures give off smell pleasant to ants' senses. Some give sweet juices and some are just pets. Green fly is the ant's cow. Why? Because the ants train it to give honeydew with a touch of their antenna. Now, as in human beings, we have cows who give us milk. In the same way, ants get honeydew from green fly. That's why it is said that green fly is the ant's cow. So these were the facts about ants. As we have read them, now there are a lot many things which we can learn from them. We human beings have a lot to learn from tiny teachers. Just have a look. The first one which we can learn from them is hard work. As we saw that ants are very hard working, so we learn hard work. Second, sense of duty and discipline. As we saw that ants are very disciplined, they always walk in lines, they always greet others, so we learn all these things from ants. Third one is cleanliness and care for young ones. As we saw that in ant hills, grubs are taken care of by workers and soldiers, so we learn that we should also take care of our young ones and cleanliness. above all, form loyalty to the land where they live. And at last, what we learn, the most important thing, loyalty to the land where we live. So this was lesson number one, The Tiny Teacher, from our supplementary reader book, which is An Alien Hunt. Now your homework is, you have to read lesson number one, The Tiny Teacher, and on the basis of understanding, you have to find answers to the given questions and do them in rough notebook. The questions are, on page number three, comprehension check. First, the story of an ant's life sounds almost untrue. The italicized phrase means highly exaggerated, too remarkable to be true, not based on facts. Second, complete the following sentences. First, an ant is the smallest dash. Second, we know a number of facts about an ant's life because dash. Third question is, in what ways is an ant's life peaceful? Now on page number 5, comprehension check, question number 1. How long does it take for a grub to become a complete ant? Second, why do the worker ants carry the grubs about? Third, what jobs are new ants trained for? Fourth, name some other creatures that live in ant hills. Fifth, mention three things we can learn from The Tiny Teacher. Give reasons for choosing these items. Exercise. Discuss the following topics in groups. First, what problems are you likely to face if you keep ants as pets? Second, when a group of bees finds nectar, it informs other bees of its location, quantity, etc. through dancing. Can you guess what ants communicate to their fellow ants by touching one another's feelers? So these are your questions. You have to find their answers after reading your lesson number one and do them in your rough notebooks. Now, we will discuss homework solution of lesson number 21 summary, that is summary writing of lecture 1. So, the question was, read the following description of an event and write a summary of it. It was a bright sunny day on 25th October 2018. That was the day when the 50th foundation day of our school was celebrated. The governor was invited as the chief guest with all my schoolmates. I was busy making arrangements for the function. We decorated our auditorium with balloons and confetti. The governor arrived at 4 p.m. accompanied by many other dignitaries. There was a beautiful cultural program where the students of our school participated with a lot of enthusiasm. The annual prize distribution ceremony was also held on this day, and the governor gave away the prizes to several students. In his speech, the governor congratulated the school management staff and the students on golden jubilee of the school and also stressed on the need of discipline among students. Now read the report summarized. The 50th foundation day of our school was celebrated on 25th October 2018 and the governor graced the occasion as the chief guest. A cultural program was held followed by the prize distribution ceremony and a speech by the governor in which he congratulated all and stressed on the need of discipline in the students. Thank you. This was all about today's lecture. If you liked this video, then please subscribe the channel.